Why did you talk with human? Don't be a victim.
The odds can be stacked against us enough without making ourselves a victim as well. So the more that we can actually own our own power, realize what are the decisions and actions, what can we do, and realize what we're doing that is hurting ourselves. Not talking, not speaking up, apologizing too much, letting others intimidate us and backing down. The more we can own our own power and take charge, the less that we will be victims of any system that we're in.
And you, did you say yet that human has a big difficulty to talk about strategy, about business plan? Why?
I think sometimes it can be this amorphous MBA concept, and people don't understand necessarily, you know, what does that mean? So I like to use the term strategic choices. And I gave examples of a few, but there's lots of strategic choices. You may have strategic choices about what product or service portfolio are you going to be offering? What markets are you going to go after? What's your exit strategy? So do you plan to be acquired, or are you going to spin out? Are there going to be certain partners that you want to have strategic alliances with? What about your marketing strategy? What about HR, recruiting, retaining talent strategies? And even thinking about, in terms of finance, what are some of those financial indicators, those KPIs? We want to make sure that we're getting those important indicators in terms of that, or even facility or equipment strategies. So sometimes strategy, people think, well, I don't have a strategy, but I just say it's a strategic choice, and that makes it simple.
And how did the human can be changed and to be obtain the leadership?
When you're trying to change an organization, you've got to change the people. And so some things can be as simple as just talking to them. What concerns do they have? Are they worried that they're going to lose their job, lose control or power in their position, or that they're not going to know how to do their new job? So we want to make sure that they understand where they are. Make the case. Why are you making this change in your office, in your company? So what's the case for it? A lot of times that will help people come along. You can also do a pilot program. So if people are hesitant to make the change, well, do it with a small group, un poco, something small, and then show, okay, now this is how this can work. And so other people can then come on board and see that, okay, as more and more people come on board, it's sort of like a wave, like a tsunami, and it gets bigger and bigger, and then we can get everybody on board with the person side of the change.
And you said about bad habits to human. Which bad habits?
Oh, well, when it comes to leadership, there's grande, not un poco. So lots of bad habits that we can have. So whether it's micromanaging our staff or whether it's changing our minds too often, there's lots of bad habits in terms of that leadership development, losing sight, losing vision. We want to make sure that everybody's rowing together in the same way.